Okay, I am Supernell, and I am here to share the top three safety tips for paramotoring for you. What are the top three ways to make yourself as safe as possible? Well, one, flat top ninja paramotor. Don't even think about flying anything else. Now, in that, it's kind of hard because that's simplifying it very, very much, because there's hundreds of specific safety features that the flat top has that no other paramotor has. So it'd be completely absurd to fly any paramotor. But this is actually number one. A lot of people think that the glider you fly is the biggest safety factor. But out of different certified gliders, I'm not talking about Hoaxflex death traps, because that would be different. But if you take any of the main name brand certified beginner class gliders, they're going to be decently safe, and the difference between the two is not as big, or even close to as big, as the difference between a flat top and all other paramotors. So let's just hit some of the main things. Let's say the number one thing that's going to save your life on a flat top is the crumple zone. That is numero uno. When you fly a paramotor, you are going to crash. Period. That is part of the dang sport. If you ride a dirt bike, you're going to dump it, okay? That's dirt biking. And if you're not, you're a sissy freaking moron who never rides and you don't know crap for crap anyway. So you're going to smack into the ground at some point. It's the way it goes. You get 5,000 flights, I guarantee you totaled at least 10 paramotors. Well, flat tops, because if you flew any other paramotor, you'd be dead. So you only total one of them. So the flat top crumple zone is absolutely critical. That allows you to total a unit and get up and walk away and then total another one another day. So kind of cool that way, works good. But crumple zone, really that's the big one, because when you fly a certified paraglider, and let's say all the name brands, in a full stall, they only fall about 20 feet per second. Now the Dominator falls a lot slower than others. Others are faster, but let's say you fall about 20 feet per second. That's like jumping off a house roof. Now, if you jump off a house roof and land flat on your butt on the sidewalk, you are going to break your back or die. So don't go jumping off your house roof and land flat on your butt. That's where flat top crumple zone comes into play. When you smack into the ground, if you don't have that 18 inches or so of crumple zone from the flat top, you are very likely to break your back or die. That's why it is so absolutely critical. Okay, the next biggest one is the quick release harness and its ability to float. There's no other paramotor on the market that can float and has a quick release harness. It does not exist. Most paramotors will sink immediately in water, and they have so many buckles that people drown. That is huge. So if you don't have a flat top, you're asking for something that's just like, it's inevitable. We love flying around water because of the lake effect, and crap happens. We like doing foot drags in the water and screwing off and doing stupid stuff and pushing the limits. And it's going to happen at some point, you might end up in the water. And if you do that and you don't have a flat top, the odds of you dying are extremely high. Many, many people have died from drowning. Zero people have ever died from drowning on a flat top. Zero. And many of them have been in the water. So absolutely critical. Now, one of the biggest safety things, this isn't really a life versus death, but really the biggest major injury among stupid people in the sport, basically anyone who doesn't fly a flat top, is getting their hands shredded in the prop. It's literally the biggest. I mean, it has nothing to do with competent people that fly flat tops, because the flat top is designed to prevent that. So that is the number one. I mean, literally over 100 people have been shredded in the prop, as well as if you don't have protection from the prop designed properly, your brake toggle can get into the propeller in flight. And as you can imagine, if it wraps up in the prop, it will lock you into a face-down spiral and kill you dead. So protection from the prop is absolutely critical. Flat top, numero uno. If you don't have a flat top, don't fly. Next, Dominator. That is the shiznit wing. It is the ultimate wing. Now, If you compare it to other beginner class wings, there's other wings that are also decently safe. The reason the Dominator is so unbelievably undefeatable right now and has no competitors is not because of the safety. It's because of the performance and safety in the same glider. If you get some Mac Para or Ozone beginner class glider, they suck so bad on performance, in 3 to 6 months, you will be buying a new glider. And you will say, oh, I don't care about safety. I'm willing to sacrifice safety to try and get some actual performance. That's the thing about the Dominator. You got even better performance than the other wings. Excuse me, better safety. But it also has the best performance on the market. This glider is outflying totally uncertified class wings. No certifications at all. So you've got the highest level of safety and the highest level of performance so that you have enough fun that you're not going to sell your Dominator. So you get a wing that you're going to keep for a very, very long time because it's not going to, you're not going to get bored with it. You keep your Dominator. If you got pretty much any other name brand of glider, beginner class, 3 to 6 months, you're going to dump it and you're going to get a different glider. And if you get that brand, even if you get a uncertified class Ozone, you still won't have the performance of a Dominator. If you get an uncertified class Total Death Trap Paramania, you still won't be able to keep up with a Dominator. If you get a totally uncertified class Mac Para, you still can't keep up with a Dominator, and they're death traps, and the Dominator's the safest wing in the market. So, makes it very, very clear, Dominator number two. Number three is Super Training. Because what you're flying is a glider. Now, active piloting of this glider makes this glider and every glider, or almost every glider, thousands of times safer. So getting real actual training is number three. Now, why is that less important than a Dominator and a flat top? You might say, well, the training would be more important. No. And here's why everybody crashes. Everybody pushes their own personal limits. So if you're a moron and or if you're an expert, you're still gonna make a mistake and at some point you might lose control. When you lose control, what are your skills doing for you? You're out of control. The only thing that's gonna save your butt is your flat top and your Dominator. So that's why these are more critical. Because even if you're the best pilot in the world, you could pound into the ground doing a death spiral at 50 miles an hour. And if you didn't have a flat top, you'd probably break your back and die. And if you didn't have a Dominator and you took a major collapse, you could easily pound into the ground and die. So the skills is actually number three, interestingly enough. Kind of strange, but that is how it actually works out. So flat top first, Dominator second, and super training specifically. Very often you hear, get good training. Well, what is good training? Good training is the ability to control the altitude of your butt using the glider. That means you can walk right up a vertical wall. Now, it doesn't matter if that vertical wall is 1 foot tall or 10 feet tall. It's not about the height of the wall. It's about controlling the altitude of your butt using the glider and maintaining that altitude, give or take 1 inch. That is beyond expert level skills, and you are only seeing that coming out of super training. Because to get that level of skill in just 10 days is absolutely incredibly difficult. It takes the best, most perfect weather so that you can practice upwards of 25 to 60 hours. So super training is absolutely critical. I mean, if you train with some complete scammer like Kurt Pfister, you literally will get most likely less than 1 hour of actual practice with your glider before you get chucked in the sky. More likely 15 minutes. Now, if you train at Aviator PPG, for example, 2-3 hours, maybe, if you're lucky, literally 0 to 3 hours of practice with the glider. Super training, you're talking 25 to 60 hours of actual practice with the glider. You can't even remotely compare Joe Blow with 2 hours of practice in his entire lifetime to Mr. Super Skills that's got 50 or 60 hours of actual glider control practice, who can control altitude of his butt, give or take 1 inch, with the glider. Now, why is that 1 inch critical? Because that is active piloting of your paraglider. How does a paraglider collapse? If it overshoots you, goes to a negative angle of attack, boom, that's when it collapses. Now, you can feel that happen almost 2 seconds in advance because you feel the pressure of the glider drop. It doesn't generally happen all at once. You get some warning. So you need to have those skills to where when you feel that slightest drop in pressure, boom, you add brakes and regain that pressure. Which, remember back to the 1 inch, if you're leaning backwards and you start falling backwards, that's a loss of pressure. Boom, you add brakes, that lifts you back up. If it starts lifting you up and dragging you, boom, hands up and you dump lift. So in the air, that skill directly translates to active piloting of the glider, making that glider thousands of times more stable. Now that's just one piece. Then you have the ability to like reverse cross control with no hands, another critical skill. If you can't do that, you cannot control a glider in high winds. Like another fake instructor got drugged, broke his ribs, and ended up in the hospital in 12 mile an hour winds. 12. Why? Because he doesn't have even the most basic ability to really control the glider. In wind, pulling brakes creates lift and drag. That means you get drugged. So if you stuff a lot of brake in higher winds, bam, you get yanked off the ground and drugged, and it gets really, really ugly. So you have to be able to control the glider both with brakes and with body only, so that you're using a lot of body input, so you're only using just the amount of brakes that you need, as little as possible. The more you can weight shift, the less brakes it takes. So think for a second, if you're making a right turn, well, if you don't lean at all, you're gonna have to pretty much bury the brake to make that turn. Well, what happens when you go through turbulence in the turn? Your brake's already buried. You got nothing left for active piloting. So it's absolutely critical that you have that ability to control with weight shift, which of course is another reason for the flat top, because it's got the best weight shift. But there are many, many details of the training. It's all about looking at the actual skill that people are attaining. One guy actually set a world record recently, knocking out 530 flights of experience during his 10 days of super training. He started from never having touched a glider, brand new, never touched one, graduated with beyond expert level skills, 530 flights. It's not just about learning every tiny detail of glider control, but about the massive, massive amount of practice that you get. No other training class in the world gives you anything even close to the experience or sheer hours of practice that super training does. And of course, super training does not put you in the sky until you master control the glider. So, flat top, number one, if you don't have it, don't fly. Dominator is absolutely the best. There's other good gliders that are good and safe, but the Dominator gives you the best performance. It's the glider that you're not gonna be trading in after 2 months. And super training. These are the top three ways to stay alive. This is because I love you. This is not a sales pitch. Anyone trying to throw out obvious, logical, factual information and claim it's a sales pitch is an evil scumbag that doesn't care if you die. This is logical, rational. You can explain every detail of why these pieces make that big safety difference. So listen to facts, logic, and reason, and throw out the bull crap and opinions. Stick to facts, you'll be safer.